Parliament consists of the office of the President of India and two houses, which are known as Rajya Sabha or the Council of States, Lok Sabha or the House of the People. Parliament can have 802 members. Rajya Sabha is known as the upper house of Parliament of India. It consists of 250 members, out of which 12 are nominated by the President of India. The remainder of the Rajya Sabha, they are elected by state and territorial legislatures. Term of the office is 6 years. One third of the members retire every 2 years. Vice President is the ex officio chairman of the Rajya Sabha. Lok Sabha is directly elected by the people of India. Lok Sabha can have a maximum of 552 members, including 20 members from the Union Territories and 2 from the Anglo-Indian communities. Speaker presides over sessions of Lok Sabha. Constitution does give the Rajya Sabha special powers over the states, but on most matters, the Lok Sabha exercises the supreme power. Any ordinary law needs to be passed by both the houses. But if there is a difference between the two houses, the final decision is taken in a joint session in which both the members of the houses sit together. Lok Sabha exercises more power in the money matters. Once Lok Sabha passes the budget of government or any other money-related law, Rajya Sabha cannot reject it. Rajya Sabha can only delay it by 14 days or suggest changes in it. Lok Sabha may not accept these changes. It is the Lok Sabha which controls the Council of Ministers. Only a person who enjoys the support of majority of the members of Lok Sabha is appointed as the Prime Minister. If majority of the Lok Sabha members, they do not approve the Council of Ministers, then all the ministers including the Prime Minister have to quit. But Rajya Sabha doesn't have this power. So we can say that both Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha are parts of the Indian Parliament, but Lok Sabha enjoys greater powers than the Rajya Sabha. Political executive, a group of functionaries is called the executive, and the executive has two categories, political and permanent. Prime Minister and the Council of Ministers, they make the political executive. The task of the Council of Ministers is to execute the programs and policies of the government. Hence, it is called as the executive. The members of the political executive are elected by the people. Permanent executives. Civil servants form the permanent executives. They are selected to All India Civil Services and they continue in their job irrespective of the change of the government. Political executive is answerable to the people, so enjoys more power than the permanent executive. Prime Minister and Council of Ministers. Political executive includes the Prime Minister and the Council of Ministers. President appoints the leader of the majority or the coalition party that has majority in the Lok Sabha as the Prime Minister. Prime Minister doesn't have any fixed tenure. He remains in office as long as he enjoys the majority support of Lok Sabha. President appoints the Prime Minister, but he cannot appoint anybody as per his wish. Prime Minister makes the Council of Ministers. Council of Ministers is composed of 60 to 80 ministers of different ranks. Various ranks of the ministers are as follows. Cabinet Ministers. They usually make up the top level leaders of the ruling party. They are in charge of major ministries. They are about 20 ministers of the cabinet rank. Minister of the state with independent charge. They are usually in charge of small ministers. They participate in the cabinet meeting only on the invitation. Minister of state. They are attached to a cabinet minister. The role is to assist the cabinet minister. Important decisions are taken during the cabinet meetings. Due to this, the parliamentary democracy is also known as the cabinet form of government. Minister may have a different opinion, but minister needs to own up every decision made up by the cabinet. Minister cannot openly criticize any decision taken by the cabinet. Every minister has secretaries who come from the civil services. Cabinet as a team is given the assistance of cabinet secretariat. The cabinet secretariat is composed of senior civil servants who coordinate the function of powers of the Prime Minister. He has wide powers. Prime Minister chairs the meetings of cabinet. He coordinates the work of different departments. In case of disagreement between two departments, decision of the Prime Minister is final. Prime Minister supervises the functions of various ministries. He distributes and redistributes the work to the minister. He also can dismiss a minister. In case the Prime Minister resigns, the entire ministry has to quit. Prime Minister is the most powerful member of the cabinet. The power of Prime Minister has increased so much that the parliamentary democracies are sometimes called the prime ministerial form of government. During the days of Congress monopoly, in the union government, the Prime Minister used to be very powerful. But situation has changed because of prevalence of coalition politics in the country. Prime Minister needs to accommodate a diverse set of political parties. He needs to pacify different coalition partners because he needs their support for the survival of the government. The president, he is the head of the state. All decisions of the government are taken in name of the president. He is just a titular head of the government. Any bill which is passed by the parliament, it needs the signature of president to become a law. All the major orders of the government need president's assent before they can be enacted. All international treaties are signed in the name of president. President appoints the Chief Justice of India, Chief Justices of High Court, and also the judges of lower courts. He also appoints the governor of states. All major appointments are made by the president. President is the supreme commander of the armed force. When no single party or a coalition is in position to form a government, it is the president who decides that who is going to form the government. In such situation, the president invites the person who he observes is most likely to secure a majority of the house to form the government. And after that, the newly appointed prime minister is given some deadline to prove his majority in the Lok Sabha. In this image, we see the President Pranab Mukherjee administering the oath to Prime Minister Narendra Modi. The judiciary, independent and powerful judiciary is considered essential for all the democracies. India has an integrated judiciary, which includes Supreme Court, High Court, District Court, and various local level courts. Supreme Court is the apex court in the country, and hence its decision cannot be challenged. Its decision is binding on all other courts of the country. Supreme Court can take up any dispute which is as follows. So Supreme Court can take up any dispute which is between citizens of the country, between citizens and the government, between two or more state governments, between the union government and the state government. Independent judiciary's main role is protecting the fundamental rights as enshrined in the Constitution of India. If any law is passed by the government at the center or state, which is viewed as overlooking the fundamental tenets of the Constitution, then the Supreme Court has the right to revoke that law. There are many cases in which the litigations have been filed on behalf of public against the laws enacted by the government. And this is known as public interest litigation. Independence of the judiciary ensures that no government can behave in an autocratic way.